Global temperatures keep breaking records this week, highlighting the extremity of this year's summer in the Northern Hemisphere. It is extreme and brings into focus the slow pace of growth and what we're seeing in terms of curbing global emissions and the impact that we're already having. Joining us now to discuss is Bloomberg's Will Mathis. Will, how hot is it and is it going to get hotter?
It's very hot, and yes. So this is the global average temperature. So it's not just, you know, one place that sets a record, but basically everywhere is unusually historically hot. So we've had record temperatures recently in China, in North America, in Europe it's been quite hot, and in North Africa the temperatures have been brutal recently, and even actually in South America, which should be in winter right now, I was looking at the temperatures there and it looks like summer. So it's really the whole world is too hot right now.
So to deal with that trend or that direction of travel, clean energy, of course, really the efforts to kind of adopt them really accelerating, that can be a very expensive prospect, Will. It can also be met with a lot of supply chain shortages. Walk us through that dynamic.
Yeah, well, it does take a lot of money. I don't know if it would be expensive if you take into account the costs of global warming and of not making those investments. The estimates are in the trillions of inaction. So, but it will take a lot of spending to invest in mining, in manufacturing, and deployment of all these materials. And it's going to be really difficult to scale up to basically change the global energy system in a few years.